First two was, and now we've got one of the smallest dogs in this competition. It's from Switzerland. It's a little chihuahua called Joya with her handler Karen. And Karen is actually, when she was younger, did 10 years of ballet, and I think that has inspired this routine to Swan Lake. What a fantastic ending, and I think that's going to be a crowd favourite. Just showing you that just because it's a small dog, it can still compete at this level. Does it, Ashley, make you want to go and get a chihuahua?
Absolutely. I want a chihuahua now. And it really does show that any dog can do Heelwerk's music. What I really loved then is that she used the dog size to her advantage. So some of those moves that we saw where she picked the dog up with both of her hands, obviously we're not going to be doing that with a border collie or bigger breeds. So she's really using the dog's size to her advantage. And what a great little character.
And a great little pose there onto her back foot. I don't think I'll be doing that in the next routine. I'm not that flexible. But also, it's just great, this little dog's character. That tail was wagging. It set off round in a big circle and was doing some distance work by running around in that big circle. And some great little highlights. And just the joyous look at that dog. I mean, it's a great name for a little dog. She's called Joya. And She is 9 years old.
Wow.
So for a 9-year-old Chihuahua, I tell you, that is amazing. Now, what will the judges think?
I'm keeping my fingers crossed for this one. I know I shouldn't be biased, but...
I know, I can't help it. Having been actually in the main arena myself with a Chihuahua, then I must admit I'm rooting for it. So we're into the eights there. Some eights again, hopefully, for the accuracy. Oh, just a little bit down for the interpretation. An 8.9 from Kim. 8.7 from V and 8.4 from Cass. So they really like the interpretation there, and it just shows you the wide variety of music, doesn't it, Ashley, that you can use. And if you find that right piece, I mean, that just suited them, didn't it?
Absolutely. I thought when that dog was trotting along, they just looked so in sync. Like, when the dog was moving, it looked like it was dancing itself. And it really just went with that beautiful classical music. Totally suited them.
So, they've gone into third place. So next, so after that tiny little chihuahua with that wagging tail, we now have our winner from Thursday representing the United Kingdom. This is Nikki with Elsa. And I'm sure she's got a lot of support in the audience today. And if you haven't seen this, it's a real treat. Nikki and Elsa won back in 2020, so it was their second win. Performing to a song from Annie. Let's watch what they can do for us today. They've had a very busy time.
It's the hard knock life for us. It's the hard knock.
Well, what energy from that team. That dog has been in the both finals over the first 2 days. This is the third time this dog is in the ring. I mean, just so much energy that dog has got. And these two, they have such a great bond between them. And this sport is such a great way of making a bond with your dog, isn't it, Ashley?
Absolutely. And that really highlighted in that routine there. Like you said, day three of competition for these two. So it really does go to show that these dogs are at the top of their fitness level. And they have to be, because 4 minutes is a long time for a dog to keep their concentration on you, not get distracted by the huge crowds that we have here at Crufts today, as well as being accurate in their routine. It's a lot we're asking from them.
There is, and there was a wide variety of moves there. And as I said, on Thursday we had some bucketography, with lots of things done with the buckets there. And the props should be used several times within the routine. The judges are going to be looking at how many times the props were used. And I think every prop there was used a couple of times. And so they were going to be analysing the content and flow. Did it flow from one move to the other? Was it just a series of disjointed tricks? And yes, it was fast and furious, but was it accurate? And did you like that music?
Yeah, definitely. I think with Hilbert's music, we've heard that song quite a few times, but it is down to how you, the handler and the dog, interpret it. And also using your positives to work with in the routine.
Yes, and it's all about creating a routine that you sell your dog basically to the judges. So in freestyle there isn't any required moves, and you can see already we're into the nines there with V Richardson, and a little lower there for the accuracy, but still interpretation into the nines again. And I'm not sure, I don't expect there'll be any deductions. I didn't see any barking or noise. And into second place with 26.43. How close is this?
That is close.
We've got our first place dog, which was the very first dog in the ring doing Aladdin, Vega, on 26.50. Then we have in second place now Nikki and Elsa on 26.43. And then Hendy from France in 26.37. So see how tight it is at the top. So here we have Cora with Little Steps, the Papillon from Germany. They're going to be performing to Puff the Magic Dragon. Well, let's see what they're going to do for us today.
This is a fairy tale about a big dragon, a little boy called Jackie Paper. And the story is called Puff the Magic Dragon. Little Jackie Paper loved that rascal Puff, and brought him strings and sealing wax and other fancy stuff. Puff the Magic Dragon lives by the sea and thrives in the autumn mist in a land. So little boys painted a string and ceiling fans make way for other toys. And one gray night it happened, Jackie Paper came no more, and Pop, that mighty dragon, he ceased his fearless roar. His head was bent in sorrow, teardrops fell like rain. Without his old best friend, Puff could not be great. So Puff, that mighty dragon, sadly slipped into his cave. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lives by the sea and frolics in the autumn mist in a land.
Lovely ending from Little Steps there, 10 years old, Little Papillon. And what I love there is I've seen Cora work before, and she always has such a lovely, sympathetic way she works with the dogs. And Little Steps there performing very nicely to Puff the Magic Dragon. Did you like that track?
I did. I don't think it would be a track that I would personally use, but I think it really, really suited him, Little Steps there. And I can't believe he's 10 years old, bless him.
Yes, this little dog has been to many world championships and Europeans, and again, it's another one that's coming towards retirement.
Oh, it's so sad when we have to retire them, and especially for Hiwatch Music, because it takes so many years to get them up to this advanced level. Firstly, we've got to train them the separate moves, then start putting moves together, putting routines together.
I mean, it's amazing. So we also heard from Kim earlier about accuracy. And what I was wondering is, how do you marry those two things up? How do you get the joy, the enthusiasm, but also make sure that the dog's accurate in its movements?
It's very fine tuning. Obviously, everything here is done by positive reinforcement. So there's a lot of toy and play involved in the training, which helps create a really happy dog. But then you've got to be careful that it's not overdone and you get a dog that's over the top in this completely different environment. But yes, when the handlers relax, the handlers enjoying themselves, it's terrific to see that amazing bond between handler and dog as they work out there.
Absolutely, and I think that's definitely coming across, absolutely, that relationship between the dog and the handler. And do you have to change things for the different breeds, or even the different types of characters within the dogs? Does that make a difference?
Yes, very definitely. You know, we hope that people will showcase moves that are very appropriate to their own dogs, which is lovely. So we're seeing unique moves for little dogs and moves that suit bigger dogs, which is what helps the variety of the sport.
Yeah.
And yes, that's important.
That's brilliant. It's absolutely wonderful to see such an inclusive dog sport. It doesn't matter. We've seen tiny dogs, large dogs. It's absolutely wonderful. So thank you very much. Thank you. We'll let you get back to your judging. A round of applause, please, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
And Fee making an excellent point there about the positive reinforcement that is used in this sport a lot. Lots of toys and treats to get these dogs to be so motivated, and that's a really important part, isn't it, Ashley, getting that motivation?
Yes, absolutely. And I think it's really important as well. They are dogs at the end of the day, and if they didn't want to do this or perform with you, they wouldn't. They would be off running away or going off and sniffing. So I think it's really important to highlight that.
Yes, and some nice scores coming in there for Little Steps. We're being really treated to some really great small dog routines today. 24 dead on into sixth place. Normally that is still a very good score, but today we're really being treated to some nice routines. And here we have our next beagle, which is running order number 8, and that is from Hungary. And this is Mia. Now, this little dog is actually Adrienne's assistance dog, so they have a very close bond. They're going to be performing to A Whole New World. So we wish them the best of luck.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride. A whole new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew. But when I'm way up here, it's crystal clear that now I'm in a whole new world with
now
you.
Now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Unbelievable sights, indescribable feeling, soaring, tumbling, freewheeling through an endless diamond sky. A whole new world.
Don't you dare close your eyes.
100,000
hold your
things
breath, it
to
gets
see
better.
Being treated to a very good example in the last three dogs of the sort of wide variety of breeds that can succeed in this sport. And there you had a beagle, a hound breed, which you don't associate with training, but look what its drive and its attitude was. It was great to see, wasn't it, Ashley?
Absolutely. And I do strongly believe that Hiwot Music is definitely one of our hardest dog sports out there. You really need the perfect combination between a dog that's enthusiastic, that loves what they do, but also calm enough to, one, carry out their positions and their tricks. Not to bark, I think there might have been a little bit of a bark there. Hopefully there won't be any deductions though, but we'll have to wait and see for those all important scores.
Yes, and these routines, if you've not seen the sport before, each of these moves that the handlers are doing have to be taught individually. Then they have to be started to be linked together. So this beagle is 9 years old, and it's taken 9 years of all these little bits of training, keep sort of building and building until we can get a routine like this. And that dog's done various routines over the years, and each one's built on the last one. So here we can see that some nice scores coming in there. So not quite so high in the content. Perhaps the dog was a little bit closer to the handler, a little bit more, and not quite so far away in its moves and the technical moves. But still, again, a good score at 23.17. And it's just that, you know, there's a lovely little three-legged walk requiring great balance from the dog, but it's that tail wagging that I love to see.
Yes, look at how happy he is. He just loves what he's doing, and that is the most important thing here. Look at both of them smiling, looking at each other. I just love that look.